Imaging brain injury and repair in former National Football League players. National Football League, NFL players, are exposed to the risk of repetitive sports-related traumatic brain injury, TBI, throughout their careers. Higher rates of delayed neurological, cognitive, and mood impairments, including dementia with aging, have been reported in former NFL players relative to individuals without American football participation. Recent research has suggested that these changes may be due to underlying brain pathology resulting from repeated TBI in the absence of obvious neurological signs such as slurred speech. Players may appear to be unaffected when they are relatively young. However, there is concern that even mild repetitive TBI associated with collision sports may lead to progressive neurodegeneration associated with dementia later in life. Dr. Jennifer M. Coughlin and her colleagues at the Johns Hopkins University School of Medicine are specifically interested in the contribution of microglia, the resident immune cells in the brain, to the processes of brain injury and repair in former NFL players. Although it has been proposed that prolonged microglial activation occurs after single or repeated TBI, this has not been directly tested in the context of collision sports such as American football. Using positron emission tomography PET imaging, Dr. Coughlin and her team demonstrated higher binding of carbon-11 DPA713, hereafter DPA, to the translocator protein, a marker of microglial activation, in brains of former NFL players compared to age-matched healthy controls. The researchers also observed significant atrophy or shrinkage of the right hippocampus in brains of former NFL players, as well as varied performance on neuropsychological tests of verbal learning and memory. Given the major role of the hippocampus in learning and memory, this atrophy may be associated with the observed cognitive decline. In a second study, Dr. Coughlin found higher DPA binding in brains of young, active, and recently former NFL players, along with limited changes in the white matter connections across the brain, compared with results from athletes who played a non-collision sport. Driven by these key but preliminary findings, Dr. Coughlin and her colleagues are now using PET to explore the binding of DPA in a larger, longitudinal study. Imaging data from 35 young, recently former NFL players between 25 and 40 years of age and within 10 years of their last game will be compared with data from 35 non-collision sport athletes. The in-depth study assessments will include a clinical interview, neuropsychological testing, targeted genetic testing, and biofluid sampling, in addition to brain imaging. The researchers hope to enroll a diverse group of former elite athletes so they can examine the effects of medical, social, and play-related factors such as position or years of tackle play. An important feature of this research is the longitudinal aspect, as participants will be asked to return for imaging and neuropsychological assessments 2 years after their initial participation. The researchers are testing whether the DPA imaging signal remains high over time spent away from NFL play, in line with persistent brain inflammation. They will also assess whether a persistently high DPA signal is associated with decline in memory or other cognitive functions. The researchers believe that this study may provide further support for prolonged microglial activation occurring as a result of repeated sports-related TBI in NFL players. If so, DPA PET may be useful in future studies of brain injury and repair among collegiate and high school American football athletes. Critically, identifying vulnerability factors and complementary fluid biomarkers relevant to brain injury and repair will also inform future research. Ultimately, Dr. Coughlin's research aims to guide therapeutic strategies to improve brain recovery and the prognosis of athletes after repeated sports-related TBI.